Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, what up? I'm trying kind of an experiment here. We've got some Roush. By the way, if you hadn't noticed, Roush is all up in this business. With him is the ubiquitous Dorsai and Mustang. I haven't seen Mustang in a while. Mustang avoids us because he's a snob. But I am trying a slightly different experiment. I'm trying to record onto a different hard drive. I don't know of any reason why the production value would be less. But I will have vastly more storage space, and that is a good thing, because while solid-state hard drives are awesome, and I figured recording to that would be great, and it is, I also run through very limited space, and it keeps filling up, and I don't know why. I think I have something slightly amiss. Derp! Even Roush isn't perfect all the time. Most of the time, 60% of the time, it works every time. Mustang has gone up the middle and Dorsai is camping base. What a noob. Noob. Noob, 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 noob. Now, you may notice that Roush is riding along here in the T69. It is the American auto-loading Tier 8. It looks kind of French. And it is kind of French. I'm not sure exactly what its heritage is, but I have a feeling that there was some slight French overtones utilized. You shut your whore mouth, cat! Yeah. Roush is creeping up in here. Now, I know there's probably a certain someone out there that should be watching this video and learning and taking notes. And he will forever live in infamy as the guy who just can't really use this tank at all. I'm not going to name any names, but if the right people are watching this video, they know who I'm talking about. Oh look, a dead IS. That guy is in for a... Whoa, hello. Hello, nurse. Surprise! Down, boy, down. Now, reload time is 24 seconds. I guarantee you he's got brothers in arms on this bad boy. Autoloaders without brothers in arms are just slow. It's continuing to back off, like a whole lot. And I myself have learned, playing the KV-2, you back up through half of your reload, and then you start moving forward again, and then you're in perfect position to unleash more hell. Hey guys, surprise! I'm back! One, two, buckle my shoe. And that guy's so scared, he just throws a rock into the dirt. What the heck is that Dorsai kid still doing in base? What a noob. Oh look, there's an ELC. That would be inconvenient. I'm going to eat you, little fishy. Well, hopefully the Carnarvon can take care of it. Because our team surely is not taking care of it. Our team is being taken care of. But as long as we got that T-28 still in base, we're good. Yes, in case you had not figured that out, that was sarcasm. Oh, JP2. JP2, unleash the fury. I haven't played my JP2 in a while. Daddy needs some of that. That's what's on the menu for tomorrow. I think Tier 8 Tank Destroyers is what's up. I'll probably be streaming that, so if anybody wants to jump in... Roush or Dorsai. Oh, thank you very much. Just couldn't get that last 140 hit points. JP2, unleash the fury of the JP2. There it is. I have not JP2'd in a while. And a couple of Radley Walters on that sucker, too. They nerfed it and it's still OP. Daddy likes. Oh, that actually didn't do as much damage as it should have. He's not really rocking the big gun. Well, maybe it is. I can't... See, that's how long it's been since I played the JP2. I can't remember how much damage it's supposed to do. Well, we've crawled back into this one. We were down 4, or maybe even 5 tanks. I wasn't paying attention after we were down 4 to 8. Roush is continuing to work that middle. And Dorsai continues to camp. Oh, no, he's not camping base directly anymore. Smarten up. One of these days, he'll get his shit together, and he'll be really good, too. JP2. I feel sorry for that T-28, but he was the one that stayed in base the entire time. And Mustang is successfully myrtleizing the entire universe. Not sure what Dorsai's doing, just camping base. Bonjour. Can we spot? We can spot most of Cap from here. Are those jackets on a line? They are jackets. Interesting.
We didn't even scratch them. Penetration. Enemy armor is damaged.
Enemy armor is hit. It's gonna be really close. Our reload time is under the wire. And by our reload time, I mean Roush's reload time. Nicey nice.
Penetration.
Where the hell did Chiri go? Two shells left, and everybody's picking on Mustang. Wow, that Chiri is really unloading into him. Oh.
Enemy armor is damaged.
Okay, reset is good. We have enough time to reload. Mustang is down. Mustang is down over a cliff. Mustang done downed himself. Oh, no reset on that one. They were actually smart enough to move. We will be able to eliminate the Panther.
Gotcha.
And then we go to work. That slows down their capping, right?
We didn't penetrate their armor.
That looked like a reset. Oh, there's the Chiri. We can slow this down even further. Ho-ho! Now we got all the time in the world to do this. Except the ELC is still out there. Well, I suppose if you want something done, you gotta do it right yourself. I think Gandhi said that right before killing 1,000 German soldiers. Oh, there's one. There's two. That's a Top Gun. Now, where's that pesky son of a bitch ELC? Reset. Yes, thank you, Tiger, you dumb shit motherfucker. Pretty much, I was not even paying attention to chat. I assume the Tiger's been spouting useful bits of information the entire time. Too bad he's horrible. Is that guy really gonna... Well, maybe. I suppose if we start capping, then they'll try and come... What is your most kill? Yeah. Pretty much 11. Roush is nothing if not able to turn it up to 11. I think Roush is going for an invader medal. That would be cool. Now, what he doesn't say is that he had 11 kills 5 or 6 times, but they were all in the PZ-1C. And while we wait for the ELC, I got myself some mustache and beard wax. Actually, I think I told this story already yesterday about how I put way too much into it and it looked like I had a starched squid on my face. It was fucking funny. I did not take pictures. There will be no pictures. There's the little ELC with his little quasi-turret. Come on back now, you hear? He should be here in about 20 seconds, I would think. One would assume. Maybe quicker. He is speedy, little bastard, but there is a lot of uphill between him and the last time he was spotted. Inimini-manimo. Like Mustang might be smoking something. Nope, I lied. It took him longer than 20 seconds, that's for sure. Hey, there he is. Hey, little fella. Interception. Very nice. Let us check out the final figures. Alrighty, what is Ace Tanker, Top Gun, Defender, Tank Sniper, and High Caliber? That's pretty much all of the medals. Can't think of anything else you could get in there. One more you would have had Radley Walters, but the team wasn't willing to feed themselves to you quite hard enough. Dang. That'll do. That'll do indeed. That's 5,000 XP on a times 2. Just let that sink in. Creamy. That's 50. Let's just call that 6,000 damage and call it even. Dorsai managed to get 2,000 damage even though he can't base the entire time. Hacks. Gold hacks. Aimbot. KV2 aimbot. Hashtag. Mustang himself, 2,360 damage. 2 kills. Stole 2 of those from Roush, I'm pretty sure. Pretty sure. The JP2 on the enemy team did a fair piece of damage himself with 4,254. And who did nothing? Oh, the IS, the prototype, the 100Y. The prototype doing nothing kind of hurts. That'll cripple your team. On our team, we had no performance out of the gun carrier, the 5916, and the 64. That's really not a big deal. Those are distraction tanks anyway. Really wasn't looking for much out of them. However, our FCM-50T doing Zippo is kind of bad, and the Carnarvon doing shit all is kind of bad, and the T-28 camping the base the entire friggin' time and then turning out 400 damage is really, really bad, and the Tiger II, who decided to cheap chirp in with his advice about how to try and win a game here and there, is only got 226 damage. And wow, somebody get some new straps for Roush's backpack, because they're pretty stretched and worn at this point. 32 for 32 shooting with 27 penetrations, 5919 damage, 2600 of that is from beyond distance of 300 meters, and he blocked 480 damage with his armor. Just for good measure. Shot 9, killed 7, traveled 3.4 kilometers, and walked out of there with no credits, because you spent a lot of gold. But they nerfed that gun so hard, you either use gold or you can't really reliably penetrate targets. I mean, you saw him bounce off of the IS-3 side just for no particular reason, but that was from a fair distance off. Imagine trying to do that with regular rounds. It just would never go through. And he got, without premium, 1700 XP, with premium, 2566 XP. Other types too. Holy sheepdog. There's not much else I can say to that. You kids enjoy.